Good morning, everyone.
Morning, meeting.
Special welcome to the Dalcy angels. We are so grateful to God for friends, families, neighbors, everyone who's here today to celebrate the day with us. Thank you so much for coming. God, parents, we thank God for you. And church, we welcome everybody of you who is here. It's baptism today, but in the church calendar, it is Mission Sunday. When we are talking Mission Sunday, we are reminded of, as a church, of our mandate. And our mandate is to go and make disciples of every nation. Secondly, our greatest mandate, it is also to take care of widows, widowers, and orphans. As a church, we need to do that role. As much as we are taking care of other people outside, let us not forget we've got our own. Let us take care of them spiritually, emotionally, and otherwise. They are ours. They don't have to start crying because we are the church in mission. Today, we also want to celebrate the birthday of Umpile Chale. Are you around? Maybe following us on social media, we are saying happy birthday to you. Then it's a wedding anniversary today of Donald and Blessings Linga. They are turning 12 years in marriage. Are they here today? Again, we are going to believe they are following us on social media. Happy anniversary. We are also pleading with the church to continue praying for those of us that are listed in the community prayers. Their names are here and others are not listed here. We know them. Let's pray for them. Let's visit them. Let's call them. Let's give them all the support that they need during the trying times. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we just want to thank you as a church once more for affording us this chance to be in your presence, to come and worship you. Special thanks, O God, it's for the parents who are bringing their children to you. It's like they are saying, Lord, we cannot do it on our own, but we need you. We pray, Holy Spirit, that as the service of baptism continues, may your spirit be with us. Flow, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise in you, servants of the Lord.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his name, now and forever.
Glory to God in the highest.
And peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayers. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God. Amen.
We may sit on him. Let us pray. Almighty God,
to whom hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that he may perfectly love you, and greatly magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. Let us confess our sins, firmly resolve to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbor. Almighty God,
Holy Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name.
And may the Almighty God forgive all those who repent, have mercy on us, pardon us our sins and set us free from them, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and give us an eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we do the weekly collect together, we are going to pray for the collect of baptism. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful Father, giver of life and power, fill your faithful people with the abundance of your grace, that all who are born again by water and the Spirit may grow into the full stature of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us pray the weekly collect together. Gracious Lord, your Son came to bring us good news and power to transform our lives. Grant that when we come as faith as church, we may be ready to meet you through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
First reading. The first reading is by
instead of Psalm 1, Canticle number 7, a song of salvation. I will read the all verses, you will respond with the evening verses. Now that we have been justified through faith, we are at peace with God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
And so we can start in our hope of the splendor of God, and we can start in the sufferings in joy.
For our hope is not in vain, because God's love has fallen our inmost heart through the Holy Spirit.
When we are still powerless, Christ died for the wicked. He died for us while we were still sinners.
We are more than conquerors through Him who loved us, for nothing can separate us from God's love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now,
and will be forever.
Amen. Second reading.
Thank you.
in your version, because your version is different from mine. And I could hear the Spirit of God emphasizing something more. First Peter chapter 2, if you don't mind, man, you can come up front again. First Peter chapter 2,
today, because
and she gave her name of his name, it's like a waste of time. So when we are selling an empty basket, can you be friendly enough to bring my basket? When we are talking about an empty basket, this represents the child. The child that is brought into the world. when did you last pray? Because unless you are born again, unless you build a relationship with God, your basket is empty.
Amen.
And if it is empty spiritually, know that the devil will always fill it with something. And once you fill it with something, you will then blame the child. Oh, let me just talk as a parent. You will then blame the child and say, we know what to say. But end of the day, I'm not saying they are free to do anything. But I'm saying, let's play our part. Fill the basket.
Amen.
As a church, we can also fill that in this basket. We can fill the joy of Christ. We can fill patience. They are here. They need to be filled in Him or her. As early as possible. Because the Word of God says, train up a child. But once more, I'm going to ask the question, now I will look up, help me, Lord. The life you are leading, is it exemplary to the child or to the children that they can stand and say, I've seen patience in my mom. I've seen joy in my parents. In the midst of pain, I know my parents don't run to other people. They don't run to Sangomas. I'll say it, church.
Amen.
Because Sangomas don't run to us, but we run to them.
Yes.
Have you ever seen a Sangoma running to us?
No.
Why are they not running to us? But we run to them. You run to them and you allow them to steal your joy. Yeah. I know I'm not going to be popular. But how are you filling your basket? Because if your basket is filled with things of God, those children, they are going to grow knowing who God is. Let us not forget parents and godparents and Christ Church. Children are not like us. They are always in a competition. I spoke about it last time. I said they are always in a tug of war because they meet people from different angles of life who are going to challenge their God. So if their basket is empty, they then easily go astray. And that is why I'm saying today, if you are doing Bible stories, can I challenge you that when you are doing bedtime stories, try and do Christian stories. Because those children you are saying you are feeling what? The basket. If you are talking cartoons, buy them Christian cartoons because they are gay. Not that I'm saying they shouldn't watch the other cartoons, but I am saying whatever that you are doing, you want to be intentional. Because we don't want to see a repeat of a Nicodemus who is there as a big man in church, honored by some everybody. But he had to crawl and go to Jesus and say, my basket is empty, is filled. And Jesus just gave him a lasting solution. You must be born again. What was Jesus saying? Build a relationship with me. Because once you build a relationship with me, you will be able to fill not only your basket, but the basket of your children, the basket of your co-workers, the basket of whosoever. Do you know that sometimes I used to talk in my other world and say, it's difficult to be an Anglican the way she treats us or he treats us. So it's serious. It's not about the young ones. Because today they might not be hearing what I'm saying. But I know their spirit is eating something. Because God is bigger than the physical. But it's us who are now adults that needs to make sure and start feeding our basket with the right thing. The last challenge is ask yourself each and every day when you wake up, what are you feeding in your spiritual basket? Because what you feed will affect not only your children, but the people around you. May God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. challenge everybody. To come, they need encouragement to faithfully public worship and personal prayer, to come to confirmation, and to continue in obedience to the commands of God all the days of their lives. Confirmation is not a graduation, but it is the beginning of a journey. Parents and godparents, the children whom you have brought for baptism depend chiefly on you. How I wish you could underline that in your prayer book and highlight it. It depends chiefly on you. If you forget the child, you remember the deed chiefly on you. For the help they need, that's why I'm asking the question. Will you help and encourage your child or your children by your prayers, by your example, and by your teaching? I like it that it's not saying will, it's saying I will. So it is an individual who's saying that vow to God. You who present children for baptism must promise to bring them up, to reject all that is evil. You are to answer for yourselves and for your child. You who have come to be baptized must declare your rejection of all that is evil. Unfortunately, I cannot. I'm a child. I'm trusting mom, I'm trusting dad, I'm trusting my godparent. So do you renounce the devil and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy what God has created?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you away from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Dear friends in Christ, let us pray for these people. God of all mercy, look on them. Put to death their sinful desires.
Amen.
Grant them the life of your spirit.
Amen.
Enable them to overcome the evil one.
Amen.
Give them every Christian virtue.
Amen.
And bring them with your saints to everlasting joy.
Amen.
May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of the darkness and lead you into the light and obedience of Christ. Amen. We are on 47 now. Praise God who made heaven and earth.
Who is his promise forever.
Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ was baptized in the river Jordan, we thank you for the gift of water to cleanse and revive us. We thank you that through the waters of the Red Sea, you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the promised land. We thank you that through the deep waters of death, you brought your Son and raised him to life in triumph. Bless this water, that your servants, who are washed in it, may be made one with Christ on his death and his resurrection, to be cleansed and delivered from all sin. Then send your Holy Spirit upon them to bring them to new birth in the family of your church and raise them with Christ to full eternal life. For all might, majesty, authority, and power are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
So parents and godparents, you must now in allegiance to Christ and pray before God and his church, the Christian faith, into which these children are to be baptized and into which you will help them to live and grow. You are to answer for yourselves and for your child. You who have come to be baptized, I'll pass that one already because it's just the parents. Do you believe and trust in God the Father who made the world?
I
name of God the Son, and in the name of God the Holy Spirit, I sign you with the sign of the cross, the sign of Christ.
Thank you. Thank you. is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
Us too.
Yes. I'm going to request a chorus. You must just find us a nice chorus. Before I get into the announcements for today, we have a special item. It's a special collection. The table, whatever you want. If I'm going to summarize it nicely, it's a special collection, and then we will just give that nice chorus nyana twice the parents are coming to do that contribution.
We have set a very high target for ourselves.
there is a box, it's clearly marked, you won't miss it. And then there is merchandise at the after the service, you will find it. It's marked, selling at 80 rand, key rings at 35 rand, license holders at 25 rand, stickers at 10 rand. And the last but not, maybe let me not say the last, it's a penultimate one. Nomination list for wardens, councillors, and DSC representatives. They are on the notice board. You are requested to nominate wardens and councillors in DSC representation. The list is there. It's separated the ones for wardens and councillors. So you are requested to consider this and consider it very much prayerfully. That when you nominate someone, you have to speak to that person, but you also have to pray for that nomination, because there is a lot of work that this council of the church is supposed to do throughout the year. So you don't just nominate someone, you have to check with them and be available to serve and pray with them as they accept the nomination. So it is very important that
Mama? No, sorry, Vanessa. Sorry, Mama.
Yeah, thank you.